Okay, if he wants to
talk to her. Okay.
Okay, so ready? Oi.
Yes, ready. Ready, Gurudeva.
Okay, Onga Gyanatim Ramrasha Gyananyana Salakaya Chakchurmitam Jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namun Gurave Gaura Chandraya Radhika Vaitadalai Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tadbhaktaya Namun Namo Mahavadannaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitana Namne Gaurattise Namun He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpati Gopisa Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Taptakahan Chana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneswari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priyam Om Vrindai Tulasi Devvai Priyavai Kesavascha Krishna Bhakti Prade Devi Sattavatrainam Bhakta Vihina Prada Lakshay Kiptascha Kamadi Tarangamadhai Kripamai Tvang Saranam Prapanna Vrinde Namaste Charana Arvindam Vajami Radhaṁ Aravinda Netraṁ Smarami Radhaṁ Madhura Smitashyam Vadami Radhaṁ Karuna Varadra Tato Mamanaste Gatir Nagati Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Srivashadi Sri Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So first of all, I offer my humble, respectful obeisances unto the feet of my Guru Pad Padma, Nitrila Pravishtam Vishnupad. Astutra Satishi Sri Madhubhakti Vedanta Srila Vaman Goswami Maharaj and Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnupad Astutra Satishi Sri Madhubhakti Vedanta Srila Narayana Goswami Maharaj. Simultaneously, I offer my humble, respectful Dhanavad Pranam, Lotus Feet of Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnupad Astutra Satishi Sri Madhubhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, Srila Guru Gandhasi Maharaj, and then all senior devotees and all of his invitations. So, continue. I will discuss about Brhad Bhagavatamrta, composed by Srila Sanatana Goswami Pad. This Brhad Bhagavatamrta, actually, that is the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam. According to the requirement of Mother Uttara, Parikshit Maharaj, he also briefly told about the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam. So I told that there are two parts of this Brhad Bhagavatamrta, one the story of Narad Rishi, and another part that is called the story of Gopa-kumara. So Gopa-kumara, he told his own realization in front of his disciple Mathura Brahmana, and how Gopa-kumara, he also attained his highest perfection. And so in previous class I also explained Gopa-kumara, he went in heavenly planet and he became the king of heaven Indra, and that means he took the position of Indra. Then he left that place and proceeded to Satyaloka or Brahmaloka, And on the way, he also met with Janalok, Tapalok, many Rishi Munis, those who meditate to Lord in the form of Paramatma. Pipalanadi Rishis, he also met with them. And they also told to Gopa-kumara, why are you going in Satyaloka? You can stay with us and meditate to Lord. And why are you feeling separation from to Lord? Because Lord resides everywhere in the form of Paramatma. Yogis, according to the yoga process, meditate to Lord because Lord resides every atom. So you can realize about Him. Even Lord also resides in your heart. Just you see in your heart and meditate to Him. Then all your problems will be solved and you will be never and feel any separation from Him. So in this way, people and Adi Rishis in Tapalokas, and they also told many Siddhanta, the Siddhanta according to the Shastra, because God is one body manifest in many forms. Vadantata vidastam jat jnanamadhyam brahmayati paramatmi bhagavanti sabdate. God is one, but He has three aspects: Brahma, Paramatma, and Bhagavan. Brahma, that is all effulgence. So Brahmagyani, according to their knowledge, try to realize His effulgence from His toenails. That is called Nakhat Duti Chandrama. Brahma actually called the effulgence of the toenails of Lord. Jyotira Bhantre Dibhuja Muridhara Sayama Sundara. In this way, Shastra also explained in the Sanskrit word. Jyotira Bhantre, inside of the effulgence, then Lord resides in the form of two hands and plays the flute. So that is called Brahma. Ganesh, they realize about Him, Brahma. Yogis, according to our yoga darshan, the philosophy, they try to understand about Him. He is Paramatma who resides in the heart of all the living entities. Devotees, according to their devotional service, they direct meet with Lord and they realize about Him. He is Supreme Personality of Godhead, Saint Bhagavan. And this Bhagavan also, two ways He manifests His form. One is called Aisarja form and is called Madhurja form. Aisarja, that is called the opulence form, that is called Sankha Chakra, Gada, Padma, Narayan form, they are also. Though devotees of Madhurja, sweetness mood, they realize about Him, Dibhuja Muralidhar, Gopavish, Benukar, Navakishur, Natavar, Narila, Arhoi, Anurup, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told to Sanatan. He is Sanatan Krishna, He is called Adyagyan Paratattva. Adyagyan means He is non-dual, without second. He is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, no one equal with Him, who will be higher than Him. But those who are devotees of Madhurya Rasa and sweetness mood, and then Lord also Himself meeting with them as like their family member, that is called Lokik Sadvandhavat Priti, as like Brajavasis, Subal, Siddham, Nanda, Yasoda, and Gopis. They never believe Krishna is Bhagavan, then only they know Krishna is the son of Nanda Maharaj, and Krishna is that is called their family's member. In this way, make friendship with Krishna. And Loka Sadbandhavat Priti, they make friendship with Krishna as like their family's member. So, this types of Madhurya Rasa. Bhaktivedanta Prabhupada gave an example once. Few persons, they went to see one big elephant. But their eyes completely also and close with the
blindfold.
And they, after touching the elephant, they return back and they describe about the elephant. Those who touch the feet of legs of the elephant, they are thinking elephant as like a pillar. Those who touch the elephant and trunk, they are thinking elephant as like a snake. Those who touch the elephant's tail, they are thinking elephant is as like a snake. And those who touch the elephant's ears, they are thinking, oh, this as elephant is as like a big lips. So according to their realization, they are speaking the elephant, and that is the partly they describe. But those who are very close, those who are very coming very close to elephant and with their direct eyes can see and touch the body of the elephant, they can completely describe about the figure of the elephant. In the same way, Ganesh, they also realized to Lord very far away. For this regard, they explain God, Bhagavan, is only effulgence. So Ganesh, Bhagavan, that is called effulgence, that is called Brahma. So this Brahma is Bhagavan, he Brahma, Krishna also told, Ayanghi Param, Ayanghi Brahma, I am Brahma also. But this Brahma is called the effulgence. This is partly true. Paramatma, those who are yogis, according to the Yoga Darshan, they little bit close, but they can't to completely see the form of Lord. For this regard, they also explain God, Bhagavan, he is only Paramatma who resides in the heart of the living entities. And our Shastra also explains Paramatma's form is as like and the shape of the thumb. Angushta pramanam. Angushta means
size of the
thumb. Are those the devotee with the devotional service and direct say to Lord and serve to him, make friendship with him, and many kinds of relationship with him, laughing, joking, embracing, kissing. So these types of devotee, they can completely, absolutely realize about God. That is called Bhagavan. He is called the human being. Lokavattu lila koivalam. He performs the lila as a human being. So now coming in this way, Gopa-kumara, he met with that people of Tapalok, Janalok. They also glorified about Lord, his Paramatma, or this way. But Gopa-kumara was not satisfied with their philosophy. So Gopa-kumara, he left the Janalok and Tapalok and arrived in Satyaloka, the place of Brahmaji. Because someone also glorified about Brahmaji's Ishtadev Sahasra Shirsha Vishnu. And he manifests from the fire sacrifice that is called Havan Kunda. And he gives some instruction to Brahma how to create, how to nourishment the people, how to destroy everything. He also gives instruction to Brahmaji. But according to our Siddhanta, Brahmaji, he is called the creator. Vishnu, he is called the nourishment, nourishment of the living entities. And Shivji, he is called the destructor. So now coming in this way, so Gopkumar, he arrived in Brahmaloka, means Satyaloka, and then little bit far away, Gopkumar, he saw Brahmaji just sitting on his asana of lotus, that is Gopadamasana. And Brahmaji meditate to Lord. Then after meditating Lord, he is performing fire sacrifice in this way. And then after a few minutes, Sastra Sirsa Vishnu, he manifests from fire sacrifice. And very nice, beautiful form of Lord Sastra Sirsa Vishnu. But here I tell to Brahma, actually those jivas are performing and her austerities, tapasya, kathor tapasya, and following the for all the rules and regulations of varnashram dharma. And after 100 births, he will come in the position of a Brahma. Sata janmai ja pumano, one who worship to Lord 100 births and following the all varnashram dharma. And after 100 birth, then he will become Brahma. But every yuga is very difficult to, every kalpa or every time very difficult to find out that these types of jivas who follows the all the rules and regulations of varnashram dharma and 100 births, sata janma. So for this regard, very rare living entities then comes in the stage of Brahma. So which kalpa, but end of the age of Brahma, and that time very find out the living entities who follows all the rules and regulations of varnashram dharma 200 years, that time Lord himself, he takes the position of a Brahma. So in this way, Brhad Bhagavatam Sanatana Goswami Pad explained two types of a Brahma. One is called Hiranyagarbha Brahma, or another is called Vairaj Brahma. Vairaj Brahma, that is called Jivatattva. One who follows the 100 births, rules and regulations of varnashram dharma. Brahmachari, Grihastha, Vanprastha, Sannyas, Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudra. In this way, 100 births. And that time he will come in the stage of Brahma. That Brahma is actually called Jivatattva. That is called Vairaj Brahma. Or another Brahma, Hiranyagarbha Brahma. That is called Bhagavan Vishnu himself. That's the Hiranyagarbha Brahma. So now coming in this way, but Gopkumar, when he arrives in Satyaloka, that Brahma's name is called Vairaj Brahma. That Brahma's name is called Vairaj Brahma. Hiranyagarbha Brahma is Bhagavan Vishnu himself. Vairaj Brahma, that is called Jivatattva. Any jivas, powerful jivas, one who follows the rules and regulation of varnashram dharma, 100 births, then he will become Vairaj Brahma. Listen, Vairaj Brahma. I am saying because Gopkumar, when he arrived, that Vairaj Brahma, he worships his Ishtadev and performs fire sacrifice and jagna and doing many stops, stuti. Om Tad Vishnu Paramang Padam Sada Pasanti Surayu Diviva Chaksuratatam Om Bhurbhu Vasha. In this way, Gayatri Mantra chanting. And also doing the ingredients in the fire sacrifice. And then Sastri Sisa Vishnu arrived and from the fire sacrifice. Then Sasrisa Vishnu, very love and affection with Brahmaji, and with love and affection, because Brahma he is called the son of Sasrisa Vishnu also. Yeah. And so that means their love and affection as like son and father. And Brahmaji also is called the Kamalajani. So love and affection with this way, and he also talked how to create this universe. And Brahmaji, and he told, Sasya Vishnu told, he gave very nice advice to Brahmaji, you don't give the benediction to demons, because demons, they are very cruel, stupid, nonsense. Because many times Brahmaji, he gave benediction to Ravan and also his name. Hiranaksha, Hiranyakashipu, most of the demon, they also got benediction from Brahmaji, and also they disturb to the living entities. And in this way, Sasrisa Vishnu, with love and affection, parental mood, he gave some instruction to Brahmaji. Gopa-kumara, he noticed and how Brahma again and again bow down in his forehead unto lotus feet of Vishnu, and doing many stops, stuti, offering many kinds of fruits, flowers to Sasrisa Vishnu, and Vishnu replaced with their and his servicial mode. Gopa-kumara, when he noticed these things, just Gopa-kumara, he was thinking, if I become Brahma, then I will serve more and more to Lord Vishnu. Just his desire coming in his heart, and he chanted this mantra, Gopal mantra, and sweet names of Lord. Sri Krishna Gopal Hare Mukunda Govinda He Nanda Kishora Krishna Asi Yashoda Tanaya Prasida Sri Vallabhi Jeevana Radhikesha. Very nicely he chanted this mantra, and his desires is coming. Every time I will say and saying one thing, this naam and this mantra is very powerful. Naam chintamani krishna chaitana rasavigra purna siddha nitya mukto avinnatvat naam naami. Holy names is very powerful. If in your desire will come, Holy name will fulfill all your desires. And the thing Sanatan Goswami Pad in Brhad Bhagavatamrta very nicely explain the character of Gopa-kumara. Gopa-kumara, he went everywhere. Ananda Padmanabh, he became also king of Ananda Padmanabh. He became the king of Jagannath Puri. Even he became the king of Indra and Sargaloka, Indra. But one thing, he saw, he was staying so many opulence in there. Opulence in there. Especially heavenly planet, innumerable also opulence. What kinds of opulence? Nice, many kinds of bhojan. Bhojan means foodstuffs are there. Many kinds of sense gratification is there. And very nice, beautiful ladies also there, damsels there, Sargalu, Nalina Ganda, Kuturucho, Annang, and Srimad Bhagavatam also. But he never attached to anyone. He never attached to eat anything, or he never attached to sense gratifications. This is the life history of Gopa-kumara. Gopa-kumara in life, he always one-pointed with Guru and Krishna. For this regard, he did not attach to anyone. I am looking, Gurudev told, most of the devotees coming in Brajamandala Parikrama, especially young girl and girl, young boy, they are seeking the opposite sex. Stupid nonsense. Gurudev many times was chastisement in his class. And Bhaktivedanta Sai Maharaj, he told this month of Karti is as like cats and dogs. Cats and dogs. Dogs, Indian dogs in the month of this Kartik, they are hankering to the opposite sex. You read Bhaktivedanta Sai Maharaj's class, these things to be nonsense. He also rascal. He told, they are rascal. They are coming in Kartik Parikrama or Dham, but they are seeking for opposite sex. That is called the two things they are committing offense, aparad. One is the month of Kartik, and another things they also committing offenses in Dham. Bhaktivedanta Sai Maharaj very nicely told, this month of Kartik, you should not chasing behind towards the opposite sex. And especially Dham, very carefully these things. And actually, same way Gurudev told, this month of Karti, you have to observe very carefully. Brahmachari and Brahmachari should not chasing to each other for their enjoy sense gratifications. Very carefully these things. Stupid nonsense. Don't do raska. They will not get any fruits of Dhamavas or Parikrama, Karti Parikrama. They will not get. And Gurudev in his lecture he taught. Once he gave very heavy lecture. In the month of Kartik, especially in Dham, you should not chasing behind to the opposite sex. This stupid nonsense, rascal. You go to hell. Gurugandha Maharaj very heavy or more heavy chastisement. Don't become a look at what is called pigs and hogs. Don't do this. And especially in Dham and especially in the month of Kartik. Most of the when they return back Kartik, they are again they also chatting. Facebook chatting to the opposite sex, man and woman, and Brahmachari and Brahmachari. Stupid nonsense, rascal. Don't do this. So what is the meaning of the 1 month you staying in Kartik Parikrama and Sadhu Sangha Bhavinam? What will do this? It is better you go to the hell, Narak. And still you are Narak for Guru Vaishnav. And what is called? Picking up from the Narak. Bring to Dham. Are you are coming down? Same way you are doing same things. As like the ones of the stool. The ones of the stool again going towards the stool. Guru Govinda Maharaj, he also gave this very heavy chastisement. So don't go this. You have to do bhajan and sadhana. And follow the life history of Gopa-kumara. Why Gopa-kumara story is saying Sanatana Goswami very nicely? Gopa-kumara, he became king also in Ananta Padmanabh. And who is the king? He is the supreme also there. He is many queens, many sweet ladies is there, many kinds of enjoying the entertainment is there. But Gopa-kumara, he never attached to anyone. Why? Because his aim and object focus and towards how to attain his perfect goal. First you determine your life how to attain your perfection goal. And second, you have to one point with the Guru. So Gopa-kumara character, these two things is here. Very important. He did not attach with any ladies. He did not talk with any ladies also. And he follows the very strictly rules and regulations of Varnashram Dharma. Sanatana Goswami in his Digdarshini Tika very clearly explained this way. Now I'm looking. Many devotees after Kartik they are saying, oh Gurudev, mind disturbed with this lady, this man, this. Why? What is the meaning of the Sadhu Sangha in Kartik? What is the meaning of Harikatha? Three times, four times you are listening Harikatha, Dham Parikrama, Ardi Darshan, taking Mahaprasad. After 1 month, your same lusty desire coming, same looking here and desire coming. What is the meaning of Dhambas? What is the meaning of observe the Kartik? What is the meaning of Sadhu Sangha? You ask yourself. You ask yourself, what is the meaning of Sadhu Sangha? This is very important. What is the meaning of Sadhu Sangha? 1 month, what you did? What is your Sadhu Sangha? So Gopa-kumara, he became king. This is true. He went in heavenly planet, Sargolokas. Because Sargolokas also, there are no any restriction. And if you go Sargaloka Shastra saying, there are any restriction to enjoy the sense gratification. And no also there are any sinful activity, papa karma. But Gopa-kumara still also, he did not attach with any ladies in there. And his focus one pointed. His focus is only how to serve to Lord. Everywhere his mind is coming. How will we serve more and more? Serve to Lord. For this regard, he became king. He became king, but desire coming to become king. Why? Not for his own sense gratification, how to serve more to Lord. This is the thing. So Sanatana Goswami Digdarshini Tika also explained this way. Maybe your question will come. Why Gopa-kumara? And his desire has come, become king, Indra and Brahma also now. And why? Only what is the reason? If I would become Brahma, but if I would become, then I will serve more and more service. This is the thing. Service almost. Seva vritti, not for sense gratification. And this is the reason. So now coming in this way, very nice, beautiful explanation of Sanatana Goswami Pad about the life history of Gopa-kumara. Gopa-kumara always absorbed to serve to Lord and chanting Nam and Mantra. Every day if you chant properly to Gayatri Mantra, Gopal Mantra, any method, your lust desire will not come in your heart. This is the process. If you not properly chant the Gayatri Mantra, many lust desire will come, many material sense and gratification will come. Because bhakti manifested one's heart, Vasudeva parabhakti. One who attains the parabhakti with Vasudeva, highest bhakti to Vasudeva, then automatically two symptoms will come. That is called jnana vairagya jat ahituka. Jnana means transcendental knowledge, vairagya means renunciation, detachment will come. Bhakti manifests inward. If you know this Nama mantra automatically give these two things. Gyan Vairagya automatically give. Bhakti manifested one's heart, these things automatically come. Vasudeva prajojito. Jat aitukam. Gyan Vairagya automatically. Gyan and Vairagya automatically come. This is the process. If you not Gyan and Vairagya, Gyan means transcendental knowledge, Vairagya means renunciation, that means your bhakti completely what? Zero, maybe minus zero. Because this is the symptom. If you are doing bhajan and sadhana, chanting holy names, associated with sadhu, or if your Gyan Vairagya not coming, so how possible you can say you are practicing bhakti? If you have to practice bhakti proper way, what is the proper way? Chant holy names. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. This is the best medicine. Are only to say, Gurudev, give me power, give me power. Are Guru, Guru and Krishna always giving power to you? Gurudev, Guru, Krishna give you the medicine. Just you drink the medicine, take the medicine. This is the process. If your Gyanavara do not come in, that means your bhakti is nothing. Zero. So you have to do. Chant holy name. Fix your mind. First fix your mind. And concentrate your mind with Krishna. You have to make your goal. This life, I'll do bhajan and sadhan. Shraddha sabde viswas kahi shudra nishchay. Krishna bhakti kaile sarva karma krita hai. And first this is shraddha. And bhakti is last or smallest particle, fraction is called. That is called shraddha. This shraddha divinity is Krishna bhakti kaile sarva karma krita hai. If I perform bhajan sadhan to Krishna, Krishna bhakti, then my life will be successful. So shraddha means from faith, vishwas. And Krishna seva vasana, desire to serve Krishna. How to fulfill the desire to Guru and Krishna? This is your aim and object. So Gopa-kumara life history this. His aim and object, how to fulfill the desire of my Guru. How to serve to Guru and Krishna. For this regard, his mind never attached with any ladies in heavenly planet or what is called Ananda Padmanab king in there, nothing. And this is the main thing. And Gopakumar, he said, Sanatana Goswami again and again in his Digdarshini Tika and the commentary of Digdarshini very clearly explained this. And so now coming in this way, Gopakumar, when he saw Brahmaji, how meditate to Lord and worship to Lord, and Brahma's eye also long time. And Brahma's one day means 1,000 Chaturjuga, Satyatrita Dapar Kali in the rotation in this way, 1,000 times. That is one day of Brahma. Then in the same way, and 1 month, 30 days,
one night.
Then coming in and 1 year, 12 months, 1 year, then 100
yes.
years, Brahma is. So for this regard, Gopakumara is thinking this way. If I go, if I get this an age of Brahma, then I can serve more and more. Age means is what? So how to serve to Lord? And if you not serve to Lord, what is the meaning of 1,000 years if you get the age? That is also usually many trees in California we saw and one tree, how many years? 3,000, 5,000 years. Dapar Yuga's trees are there. 5,000 years before Kurukshetra Yuddha came. And that tree is also there. 3,000 years of those trees are there. So that means they knew their trees, they knew all the things of the evidence of the world, what is going on. So what is the meaning? If not do bhajan and sadhan, you will become that trees, 1,000 years age of trees, or 1,000 the age of elephants. And we are human being, how many years we are living? Not more than 100 years. But elephants, they live about 500 years. Tortoise, they live 300 years. But what is the meaning of their life? Useless. Varam pancha dinani to. But if you live in this material world 5 days and do bhajan and sadhan, your life will be successful. And if you get the 100 births as like Brahma and serve to Lord, that is also good. For this regard, Gopakumar, he wanted to become Brahma. If I would take the position of Brahma, then I will serve more and more. And those who are the pure devotee, they want good health. Why? Because with their good health, I can do bhajan sadhan to Lord. More and more I serve to Lord. And Visayi, materialistic people, they want good health for enjoy their sense gratifications. Those who are materialistic part people, materialistic people, Visayi, they want good health. What do they mean? Why they want good health? To enjoy more sense gratifications. And enjoying many things, all those stupid nonsense rascal things. A devotee, they want so good health. Why? If my good health, then I can chant more and more holy names. I can then serve to Thakurji very nicely. If I have good health, then I can serve Thakurji. They can serve Thakurji very nicely. And I can preach Harikatha. If my good health, I can preach good health. Hey, if I have good health, I can preach more and more Harikatha. If I be sick, old age, I cannot speak. For this regard, devotees, pure devotee, they want good health for Krishna Seva. This is the difference between and materialistic people, good health, and devotees, good health. In the same way, because your question will come, yeah, why Gopa-kumara? He wants to become the position of Brahma. Maybe the question. Because Gopa-kumara is thinking, if I want to become Brahma, they can even serve us. I serve to Lord more and more. This is it. This for this reason. So Gopa-kumara just he chanted Gopal Mantra. Always saying this Gopal Mantra is powerful, fulfill all your desires. Gopal Mantra, one name is called Mantra Raja. The king of all mantra, Mantra Raj Gopal Mantra. Our Padma Purana also so many glorifies about Gopal Mantra. There are many mantras are in there, but Gopal Mantra is called Mantra Raj, king of all mantra, Mantra Raj. So he chanted Gopal Mantra and also chanted his sweet holy names. And he thinking, how will he become Brahma? Then something is happened, because when pure devotee's desires come in, then Yogamaya, she arranges everything and fulfills all his desires. And that time also Brahma's time finishes. Yogamaya arranges this way. Brahma's 100 years finish. Then that Brahma left that place. Understand? This is the process. But I told that which that Brahma? Which Brahma? Vairaj Brahma. Jivatattva Vairaj Brahma. And this that Brahma. Jivatattva. And then Gopa-kumara, he took the position of Brahma. And he's taking there in this way. But one thing is for also, who is Vairaj Brahma? He has four heads also. Brahma. But Gopa-kumara, he did not change his any body. His figure not changed. Maybe you have seen the Brahma's figure. Very nice, beautiful form. Four-headed. Somebody also saying his, what is it called? Long white beard, but Brahmaji has not long beard. Because many people just they are thinking, oh, he's old man, must be he has beard.
Speculation.
Actually, this is not true. Brahma has no beard. Those Shastra saying, Patika, Vriddha Patikai, Srimad Bhagavat Sloka also saying, he's Vriddha. Vriddha means he's not old. Vriddha means who is very. And what is called?
Wise.
Vriddha means who has vast of knowledge.
Wise man.
Because there are many meanings. Vriddha means vriddha. And as we are saying, kechi di gyana vriddha, kechi di vayu vriddha, kechi dhana vriddha. He vriddha means he is what?
Full of potency.
That is called, we can say, sakti. Who has sakti? Which Jnanavriddha means he is what? Who has vast of knowledge, Jnanavriddha. He is Vriddha. Vriddha means he is not old. Who is Dhanavriddha? Dhanavriddha, who has vast of
wealth.
So in the same way, people are thinking this, and because Srimad Bhagavatam giving this sloka, this is sloka is coming. Ye padikai vriddha. Yeah, vriddha means and wise, vast of knowledge. Brahma has no, some also Gurudev told once, and Brahma actually has no beard. No, Brahma's form is very nice, beautiful form. In these things, because how possible in Satyalokas they will become old age? That is achievement. Even Sarvalokas no old age, because they drinking the amrit. Amrit by nectar. Those who are drinking nectar, how possible they will become old? Their old age will come, and gray hair will not there. Just some people also speculating, because the people are looking the watching the TV, mundane people picture, they think, oh, Brahma must be this. Actually, this is not true. So now coming in this way, Gopa-kumara, he became the position of a Brahma, but his body as like Gopa-kumara. Because why? Because I told when Gopa-kumara, after departure from his guru, Janta, Gopa-kumara second time met his guru in Jagannath Puri on the beach. And that time his guru gave him blessing to Gopa-kumara, this is your transcendental constitution form, Gopa-kumara. And Sakharas also, Gopa-kumara. Sanatana Goswami Pad explained Gopa-kumara. Actually, he's Sakharas. understand? Sakharas. Sakharas means friendship mode. And this thing. So, Gopa-kumara, this is Gopa-kumara, though he became Indra, also the same form, he did not put or the crown on his head. Very simple way he's taking that. Understand? Very honorable person, but he did not use any royal dress. Gopa-kumara, always was staying very simple dress. He did not use any royal dress or any kinds of ornaments. These things. And in the same way, here Sanatana Goswami Pad explained, though Gopa-kumara, he took the position of Brahma, but he did not took the form of Brahma. No forehead, not other things, but simple way. Because always staying in his own transcendental consciousness form, that is called Gopa-kumara. Sakharas. This is very important. This. Now coming in this way, Gopa-kumara is the Brahma. And position of Brahma in Satyaloka. Another thing I tell you, in the all these actual Brahma, Indra, they are not name of the person. That is the position and the name of the position. I will give you the minister, different types of minister, financial minister, and education minister, Shiksha Mantri, and educational department, head of the educational department, educational minister, and agriculture minister, Kṛṣi Mantri, military, and minister, defense minister, that is called defense minister. So defense minister, actually the position, pod, which qualified person, then prime minister will be give the position. Okay. Satraj Singh, you are the what minister, defense minister. Just give the name. So this is a Brahma, Indra, actually not the person. That is called the name of
the position.
Position.
Post.
This is the thing. But this is also selected in there, how long you will be stay in your position. Yeah, these are the things. Yeah? Indra's eye, Indra's age, Brahma's age, everything also described in our Srimad Bhagavatam. So now coming in this way, Gopa-kumara is now Brahma, that means the position of Brahma. And he very nicely served to Lord and creates everything and solve all the problems of the demigodies. And because most of the time demons they attack to heavenly planet, and so demigodies they used to come Satyaloka and they also complain to these things, he Pitamaha and grandfather, to solve our these things. And understand this way, such as given example, Prithvi Devi, she suffered the sinful activity of demon, and then Prithvi Devi manifested form of cow. Then she came in Sargoloka and she asked all the demigodies to help to her. That in demigod and demigodies, they brought, they came on the beach of ocean of the milk, Khir Samudra, where Lord Vishnu is taking rest. And then actually they came by the headed by Brahmaji. Understand? Because Lord Krishna, Lord Vishnu, he does not direct listen any prayers of demigodies also. The demigodies, they gave report to Brahmaji. Then Brahmaji, he give the report to Lord Vishnu. This is the process.
So he is also demigod.
Eh?
Senior most demigod.
Sarvottam.
But not a demigod.
Higher the demigod. This
position for a higher demigod.
So they coming in this way. So our Srimad Bhagavatam also explained this way, other Puranas explained this. That time when Brahmaji came with all the demigodies on the beach of ocean of the milk, then Lord Vishnu sleeping, then Brahmaji doing many stops to think, then Lord raised his eyes and opened his eyes and he listened their prayers. Then Lord Vishnu told him, Brahmaji, don't worry, you return back and soon all your problem will be solved. Then he also pulled out two hair. One is white hair and another black. That means white hair is the personification of Baladev Prabhu, or black hair the personality of Krishna. That means Lord Vishnu told my master Baladevandana Samsundar Krishna Balaram, they soon appear in Prithvi Loka. Prithvi Loka means material world, and they will be solve all the problems and reestablish Varnashram Dharma and kill the demon and save and also protect the sadhus paritranam saduna vinashaya dustitam dharma samsthapanartha sambhavami yugi yugi. This way also. So I am saying in this way. So if the Brahmaji is, this is a duty also. Is listening. Gopa-kumara now he is the position of Brahma. So many responsibilities. If you are the higher officer, you have so many responsibilities. And more headache. You are ordinary servant, no headache. And if you are the owner of the house, big headache. Or no electricity, no water, no this. Or if you are just ordinary, so no headache. Understand? Your children not thinking, yeah, how this will be fixed, they are not thinking. But you have to think. The things, how will they fix
it?
Because he's the supreme of your house. So supreme means your house. Just to give order, this light is not working. You put the light. But while they put light, how to fix the light, this is his duty.
He's just talking about you.
Oh, yeah. Huh?
He just come to the
and on
the you're the boss.
Who is the supreme controller? He has more
responsibility.
Just I give an example. This house, small house, your house. Your responsibility is everything. If not one bulb is not working, then children say, Papa, why not this working?
Yes.
You have to fix.
Jamadar, we have
toilet we saw. Toilet is not working.
Yes.
Everything they have to do. They have no responsibilities. So it's in the same way I'm saying the Brahma and his great position, highest position. But his highest position means big headache. Every day, demigod is they are coming and complain these. Understand these things. How to maintain these. Then Brahmaji can sometimes Brahmaji cannot solve himself. Then Brahmaji he also pray to Lord Vishnu. Vishnu comes. Then Vishnu tells, okay, I will solve. Vishnu very easily because he is Bhagavan.
He is
Bhagavan. Kurtum he is called Isvara. Bhagavan means Kurtum, Akurtum, Kurtum, Anatha Kurtum, the Samartha Sri Bhagavan is the Vacha. Which possible, impossible, possible, impossible, impossible, possible. He can do everything. Understand these things. And very to easy. Just his desire, then everything will be solved. We cannot do anything. If I think, why this light is not working? We have to fix. But Lord, you think, why not working? Lord think, hey. Then light comes. Because he is Satantra Sechamaya Purus. Ichchamaya. Ichcha means you. He said, all his desires are going. He wants this everything. No need to go and fix everything. Just his desire. Hey, bulb, give light. Then bulb, give light. He is Bhagavan, these things. And Brahma is not Bhagavan. Brahma actually is called Vartatva Jivatatva. Brahma also is Jivatatva. Just he, with his bhajan and sadhan, or harvest is coming in the highest position. But he, how long will he stay? According to the age of 100 years. After 100 years, then he have to give up this position. This thing. Ah, Brahma Bhuvanaloka Punanuvartiso Arjuna. In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna also says, hey Arjuna, one who attains the Brahmaloka, even he will become the Brahma, then he will give up the position of Brahma, then again he will return back. Ah, Brahma Bhuvanaloka Punanuvartiso Arjuna. Because this thing. But those who perform bhajan and sadhana to Lord, then going direct to Goloka Vrindavan, Dita process. Sari Varnasrami Yadi Krishna Nahi Bhaje, Shasra Karma Kurdisi, Rogulobe Purimaji. And if you follow all the rules and regulations of Varnasram Dharma, but not do bhajan and sadhana, not chanting holy names, so after your death, you will go to the hell. And this is the problem. So if you get the highest position, Bhadiru bhajan and sadhan. But so, why am I saying? Because Gopa-kumara, he took the position of Brahma. But he performed bhajan and sadhan. Always he chanted holy names. Always he chanted Gopala mantra. If you have some work, but sometimes we forget to chanting holy names. It will little bit hard work. Then go, Maharaj, today I did not get time to chant holy name. Today I also forget to chant Gayatri mantra. Everybody is saying this. I will go, hey, to chant. Why I forgot? Why? Oh, I have this come, this for this reason, for this reason.
Too tired.
And no. Gopkumar in his life always another things. He always what? Chant his name and mantra. And 1.8 Guru Padapada. Gopkumar already saying these things. Hey Madhura Brahman, listen to my life history. I always want for the Guru Pad. One life, if you surrender to Guru and remember to Guru, then your life will be successful. And always remember to Guru. One life you sacrifice for Guru, tan man jivan, tan man dhanam, Guru Pade Arpan. Very, very easy to say, tan man dhan. What is the meaning of tan man dhan? Body, mind, money, everything I am offered to Guru. Tan man jivan, Guru Pade Arpan. You are singing or not, Guru Vandana? Tan man jivan, Guru Pade Arpan. Are you only to lotus, only to lips and wish? Are you offered to Gurudev? Tan man jivan dhan. One life. And become brahmachari. Very difficult, hard to me. Sometimes saying, devotee are saying, oh, it is very difficult to hard for me to become brahmachari. So what do you do? Then you agree, then understand. Then understand or not. Dilli ka laddu jo khaya, wo bhi pastaya, jo nahi khaya, wo bhi pastaya. And who is a brahmachari thinking, oh, grihastas are very happy. And those are grihastas, the brahmachari life is the best life. So much anxiety and sadness, this thing. So much suffering also. So much suffering. How much suffering to practice brahmachari life? And you can see, if you enter household life, how much, thousand times will be suffer than brahmachari life. To understand these things. People, they don't understand these things. Thousand times they are suffering than the
more anxiety.
Brahmachari life to grihastha life. So many responsibilities, so many. I'm looking, I'm going to the yes? You have to wake up, no chanting, holy name, no time, bring your baby or child to the school, this way, and this thing, anything, many problems. You have no time to chant holy name. What is your time? You can ask yourself, what is your time? Go this thing, how to maintain the house? Without money, how to maintain your life, how to maintain your children, how to maintain your wife, house, and also? Many things also, many responsibilities, so many responsibilities. And thousand times responsibilities, then the brahmachari led to? Grihastha life. But people, they don't understand. They want to, no, I want to marry, I want to become grihastha. Chakho something, then. But once time you enter and cannot come out. And swaha. So I understand. Throw the ingredients in the fire, you cannot take back. You cannot go away. Very difficult. You have to brahman, you have to suffer. Maya Devisi is very difficult. And you cannot go out from the fire sacrifice. You have to suffer. Die there. But still the stupid nonsense, rascal people, they want to become mad. And I'm saying, no, chant holy name, one life. Are one life become brahmachari, one life be bhajanasa. Why you are going? You are looking everywhere. Why knowing to jump in the fire? Gurudev told. Why? You know, you are looking. You are looking your parents, you are looking your forefathers, how they are suffering. Everybody is looking. You are looking or not? So why you are jumping again and again? Hare do bhajan and sadhana. One life. Chant holy name. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. This is the story of Gopa-kumara life. Now Gopa-kumara in the position of a Brahma. Body absorbed with Guru and only chant holy names and Balloon. And Vishay, and he never attached to Vishay. Vishay Tarango Natare Badhive. If you want to enter the Guru Pad Padma and do Bhajan Sadhana, you will never affected with and material things. This is the process. And understand this. We chant holy name. Gopa-kumara, he became Indra, he became also Brahma, but his mind never that is disturbed. His mind never disturbed.
Who was Brahma's guru?
Brahma's guru. Brahma, he got this mantra from Krishna, from the flute.
His guru and
Krishna. Vishnu,
then
Brahma
Sangha. Brahma was devotee of Lord Krishna. Devotee of Brahma.
Brahma's guru, Brahma, he took diksha from.
He was not devotee of Brahma, he was devotee of Krishna.
Gopa-kumara, he took diksha from Jayanta. Jayanta, his guru. That Jayanta, actual Lord Vishnu, manifested in the form of guru.
But he was devotee of Krishna. Why did he go to Brahmaloka?
Because he want to be, he want to serve to more and more to Lord. I told. He went to Brahmaloka and he want to become Brahma. Why? He want to serve more and more. If I get money, then I serve to more. Money is not bad things, but how to utilize that money? This is the things. If I get money, then I build big temple. Many devotees will come. Many people will and do bhajan and sadhana in there. Our materialist people think if I get money and that time that is my house and only my relative, my person, they will be stay. So this is the difference between one the difference between materialistic people and devotees. And if you think this house belongs to Guru and Krishna, so this house have to stay devotee. Or if you know this is my house, only my wife, my children, they can stay. That is a materialistic idea. House is very good. You have money, you can build the house, but utilize that the house.
How
do you use the house?
What you use the house for?
You think, you know, the house belongs to Guru and Krishna. Devotee will come. Devotee can stay. Raman Vihari Kunja. I gave the idea. Still, you and the coconut is here. I heard you. So.
Yeah.
The coconut is here. So, you think this house belongs to Krishna? Just I am the take care. Just I am looking.
Caretaker.
I am not the owner of the house. The house, Thakurji, Raman Vihari Thakurji. Understand? I'm taking care. And this is the difference between materialist people and the difference between devotee of Lord. So you are devotee of Lord. So you are thinking, no, this house belongs to Raman Vihari. And I am just working on behalf of Raman Vihari. This is the thing. So all you think, this is, so far this is called Shastri, Griha Mandir. Mandir means a temple. House is as like a temple. This house is Griha Mandir. This Griha is Mandir. Mandir, temple. Who lives in the temple? Thakurji. Just Griha, I am staying. Griha means here. No Griham Grihini Chuchyate. Griha and Mandir, little bit difference again. Only when you use the Mandir, two things, Griha and Mandir. So you are using here two words, Griha Mandir. Or we are using this word? Temple, Mandir. That difference is there is no wife. Understand? And when Griha Mandir, that time your wife and children are there. And Santa Mahatma coming, going, not regular stay. And not permanent, what is called?
Resident.
Resident of sadhus. Just coming and going this way. But your wife, children are taking care. A temple, the sadhus are staying in there. That is called only temple, mandir. And mot and mandir. Or griha mandir. So use this word, the griha. Griha means you have wife. For this regard, this is called griha mandir. You understand? And one is called only mandir, or another is called griha mandir. Your house is also griha mandir. Because here your wife is here. And Matha means matanti, basanti, jatra, chatra. That is called matha. Matha means well. Where the devotees living together and also chanting holy names, reading, learning, teaching to each other. That is called matha. Nityananda Prabhupada, he gave the definition about the Mata Mundi. Gur Premanandi. Everyone do bhajan and sadhana in this life and come to this surrender to Guru and Krishna. Gaur Premanandi. Jai Shri Gurudevi Ki Jai 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 Sri Radhe. Thank you for everyone do bhajan and sadhana. Give up all kinds of sense gratification. And those who criticize to Guru and Krishna, never associate with them.
Se alguém se associar com Guru Krishna, não se ofender, a gente deve se associar com eles. Isso aí, ó. Já está grande.